Student, welcome back for the second part of our revision video of the lesson Earth in Solar System. We have already covered the lesson before vacations. This is the revision video of the same lesson. In previous part, we have discussed about solar system, especially the difference between stars and planets. What are the stars? What are the planets? And what are the differences between these two? Okay. So today's part will be discussing some of the subtopics of the same lesson. So let's begin. So first point that we'll be discussing is constellation. Okay. So in our previous video we have discussed about constellation. So it is nothing, it's though the word seems longer, but its meaning is very simple and very easy. So what is that? So if you look at the sky at night and if the sky is clear, so you must have noticed one thing. What is that thing? The stars, if they are coming closer to each other, they create different patterns, they create different shapes. Okay. Some stars, if they are coming together, they are making sometimes triangular shape. Some stars are making square shapes. So different shapes are created. The shapes which are created by the stars by coming together, that is called as constellation. Okay, it's very simple that the formation or the coming together of the stars and making a particular shape, that is called constellation. It's very simple one. Constellations are the group of stars that form pattern in the sky. Okay. The shapes you see all depend on the point of view. Means the shape that you can see in the sky of stars that are dependent on what side you are, on what directions you are looking at them. If you are looking from the eastern side, you may see a different shape. If you turn towards other side, suppose you are turning towards north, and you are looking at the same stars, there are chances that you may see different shape. It depends on what sides you are looking at them. Okay, so the patterns are created of stars that are called as a constellations. They are constellations. Stars in constellation are not close to each other, but when viewed from the Earth, they seem to be grouped together. Actually, the stars are away from each other, they are not closer to each other. But when we are looking at them, they are looking to us like they are coming to close to each other. And they are creating particular shapes, they are particular designs. These designs of the shape are called as a constellation. Okay, I hope you must have understood this. So there are certain facts about the constellations, you can see here. There are 88 total constellations in the world and they are creating different patterns, different shapes. Some constellations move over the year, means they sometimes they are changing their places. Some of them, not all. And so one of the constellations has the planet Mars in between them. So Mars is between them in some of the constellations. Every constellation has a story of how they came to be and what they mean. Or represent. Okay. So most of the constellations and whatever the name or the people have given to them, most of the names are given by Greek people. So they are Greek words. They have certain particular meaning. Sometimes they are given particular names because they look like particular animal. They look like particular shape. The name of that shape is given to that particular constellation. Okay. Here are some of the examples of constellation you can see in the sky also if you are able to see the clear sky. So the first one is Hydra. Okay, Hydra, this constellation, if you see the shape of this constellation, it has created a particular pattern, isn't it? You can see on the smart board, it has created a pattern. Okay, and this pattern looks like a serpent, it looks like a snake. Isn't it? You can see it look like a snake. That's why this name is given to Hydra and the meaning of that word is similar to snake. It looks like snake. So Hydra, it is known as sea serpent, and it can be seen between January to May mostly, and that is also in southern hemisphere. Southern hemisphere it can be seen mostly, and it can be seen between the month of January and May. It is the largest constellation. It is one of the largest constellations that you have in the sky. This is Grus. Grus is looking like a flamingo. Flamingo is a bird, and this pattern which look like a flamingo is called as a Grus. Okay, so this shape has been created, like you can see. These are the legs. Okay, and so this name is given as a Grus. This is one constellation that you may see in the sky. This is also very important that can be. This has got Indian name. What is that Indian name? It is named as a Saptarshi. Why it has been named as a Saptarshi? You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are 7 stars. And 7 means Sapta. That is Saptarshi. It was given this name by because there are 7 stars. On that they have got this name as Saptarshi. This pattern is easily seen in India. In our country it can be seen easily. This Saptarshi pattern can be seen in India easily. Okay. So this is one of the Ursa major, the great bear pattern that has been created. This type of shape is created of stars. This is also known as a Ursa major. That is mentioned in the that is mentioned in your lesson, that is mentioned in your geography textbook. Okay, here is one again what type of pattern you can notice, that is we can say swastik like of symbol is created, and that is also a Big Dipper, or this is also a called constellation. Okay, this constellation is also can be seen in the sky. So contain examples like the planets. Our solar system has 8 planets, as we have already discussed many times. And there are 9 planets up to 2006. There were considered 9 planets, but now people are considering scientists have divided into 8, and they have Pluto is not now considered as a planet, is not planet now. So it is considered as a drop planet. Here is the list of these planets. Okay, Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. So if you want to remember these all names, if you want to remember all the names of this planet, here is one trick given. So if you want to remember the name of planet, here is one sentence. My very early morning journey start up north. So this is also one trick. One more trick is given that I will discuss next time. So MPEMJSUN. So my very early morning journey starts up north. This trick can be used to remember the name of planets. One more trick I will share in the next video. Then Mercury is the smallest. Then Mercury is the smallest planet. One fact is given for the Mercury, and it is nearest to the Sun. About Mercury, then which planet has the largest solar system? Which is the largest in the solar system? That also here. Okay, this was all about the constellation. Then we discuss about the planets. Okay, so there is one more thing and one more very interesting activity that you can do at your home. So I'll be sharing a video on that. So what you have to do? Okay, so you are at home and this interesting activity you can do, and it requires very few things. That few things are mentioned in the video that I am going to show you now. What you have to do, you have to practice this at your home, and what can be pruned with this activity. So you must have observed that at night you can see different stars, but at day you are not able to see them. Moon you are not able to see most of the time at daytime. Sometimes you are able to see, but most of the time you are not able to see. Why it happening? Why it is happening? It is happening because the sun rays and sunlight is more brighter at daytime, because it is more close to us. Okay, but it doesn't mean that there are not stars at night, the day rather. Okay, there are not stars at day, but we are not able to see them because of sunlight. Okay, so for this you can do one experiment. You require some of the things like torch or paper, and these things are easily available. So you take help of your parents, or you can take help of your elder brother or your friend also, and try to do this experiment at your home also. So I'll be showing you how it can be done. So here is that video, you watch it very clear.
Thank you.
what you have to do in this activity, you have to code you. Okay, so you have to try this activity at your home. It requires only few things. You practice and can get experience of daytime and stars, why the stars are not shining at daytime.